huh, it looks like this person is having the same crash issue I'm trying to solve. I wonder if there's any solution to these answers. What makes you think a glorified phone could run a game beyond the scope of Candy Crush? You could buy a real computer and stop wasting people's time? Thank you for the love? Well, screw you, Internet! Welcome to the Low Spec Gamer, the show where we explore the things we can do to play games on low-end hardware, no matter the sacrifices. What I have already talked about Fallout 4 in the past, I was curious to see if any of the newer mods could help me get it so low I could play it on an IntelHD GPU. So, let's get right to it. Thank you to Maelstrom for sending me the mods and files that inspired this video. Fallout 4 is a late 2015 game running on the Creation Engine, which is technically the same engine the original Skyrim uses, although it was modified in many ways for this game. The minimum settings mention an i5-2300 and a GTX 550 Ti on its minimum spec, which is why once again I'm breaking out the dual-core Intel Celeron G1840 budget CPU with its Intel HD. I choose this CPU for two reasons. It is a bit weaker than the i5-3317U on the first generation Surface Pro, and much weaker than the i5-6500HQ on the Surface Pro 3 on that post that I showed in the start. The second is that I have been experimenting with overclocking this Intel HD, and I wanted to see if that would help in Fallout 4 as well. I'm going to be using a couple of mods in this video. In the current version of Fallout 4, for mods to work, you need to go to your Documents folder, My Games, Fallout 4, and in there you should see a file called fallout4custom.ini, and if it's not there, create it, and make sure it has the correct file extension. And in that file, under Archive, make sure to have these variables, they will also be in the description. The first is Insignificant Object Remover. That is the most descriptive name I have seen in a mod in a while. This mod removes a ton of tiny objects from the game, and that's pretty much it. I would recommend this mod even for people with decent components, since you barely even notice the difference. This can easily be installed using the Nexus Mod Manager. And then we have Ultra Low Resolution Textures, which substitutes all textures in the game for some really low versions, something that can be really important when gaming on an integrated GPU. This can be installed using the Nexus Mod Manager as well, it just takes some time to install, so be patient. Regarding the configuration file, I will be using the file link in the description, which was sent to me by Maelstrom and does a great job at reducing a lot of effects. If you want to learn how to tweak the configuration file yourself, I recommend checking out my original video. Two observations are important. You must set the SD3D device variable to the correct GPU on your configuration file, and if you're going to try and use low resolutions in full screen mode, you must either set the file to windowed, borderless and use this upscale mod, also linked in the description, or add that custom resolution to your GPU's control panel and set the game to exclusive full screen. With all of that done, I set out to see what kind of experience I could get on this game after all of those changes. Looking at the game through these textures, you can't help but wonder why weren't low textures included as an actual option for the game, and why would we need to rely on mods for that? I have my theories, but I mean, a lot of modern games still have options for pretty low textures, but I guess a lot of developers already assume that there's no need for them, because most people have decent computers, which is an assumption I aim to challenge. It may also have to do with a lot of developers not liking looking at the games like, well, this. Well, that's not something I want to fight with. Wait, did I? Oh, I'm screwed. But oh my god. That did not do as much as I expected. Oh god, no, I missed. This is... I mean, okay, look at it this way. This is as intense. That might not have been the best idea. Oh god. Oh god, no. I'm dead. I would have thought making it very low resolution would make it a little bit less scary. Nope. What the f- okay, did I miss all my shots? Mmm, I'm not doing very well, are I? Oh, no, 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 not again. Seriously? Oh god, oh god! Wait, there's two of them? There's two of them?! Are you- no, 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 no. Get out of here, get out of here, run. Run, 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 run. I don't care about my companion, not really. I'm sorry, some sacrifices have to be made in the name of... survival?
While playing a modern AAA game on these conditions is not exactly for everyone, it is interesting to see just what can be achieved if you are determined enough. Thank you to the donors on Patreon for making these videos possible. See you on the next one.